Let's mold in the Central Committee. Let's cringe in the Central Committee.
I want to give you some hopium. Who wants hopium up in here? We'll go down. We'll be pessimistic later. I feel like we should get some hopium. Apparently, there's been a lot more chatter about basically overturning the filibuster. Manchin calls for enormous infrastructure package paid for with new taxes. The Democratic senator said he favors rolling back parts of Donald Trump's 2017 tax law to fund a bill with the goal of rebuilding America. Senator Joe Manchin said Wednesday that he favors a large infrastructure package that would be paid for in part by raising tax revenues. I'm sure of one thing. It's going to be enormous. The West Virginia Democrat, who is seen as a swing vote in a chamber divided 50-50, told reporters at the Capitol. While he didn't predict a price tag, Manchin said Congress should do everything we possibly can to pay for it. He said there should be tax adjustments to former President Donald Trump's 2017 tax law to boost revenues, including raising the corporate rate from the current 21% to at least 25%. The tax benefits in the Republican law were weighed in one direction to the upper end, Manchin said. He also suggested an infrastructure bank paid for by with revenues, potentially a value-added tax that would be used for rebuilding America. I'm not afraid to look at other things, he said. Notably, Manchin said the Republican resistance to higher taxes was not a reasonable position in an infrastructure negotiation. Where do they think it's going to come from, he asked. How are you going to fix America? Manchin's position on taxes signals a significant division between the two parties that could nudge Democrats to pursue the same budget reconciliation process that they used for COVID-19 relief to pass an infrastructure bill if they cannot reach common ground with Republicans on how to finance it. The senator's remarks come as Democrats grappled with whether to go it alone again or try to pursue a bipartisan deal to secure the 60 Senate votes needed to pass a bill through the regular process, which would require at least 10 Republicans. President Joe Biden's advisors are drafting a $3 trillion package. That's a big package. That's a big fucking package. That's a gigantic package. That includes provisions on infrastructure, renewable energy, and boosting the workforce, alongside tax increases to finance it. Even Susan Collins of Maine, one of the most moderate Republicans, there's no such fucking thing as moderate Republicans. There's no such thing. $3 trillion, chat. That's more than our nuclear arsenal and the F-35 combined. They're spending more on infrastructure than our nuclear arsenal and the F-35 what? Amazing. Is Manchin trying to waste one of our three reconciliation bills on common sense things? I mean, a $3 trillion package on infrastructure and renewable energy is not a small thing. Don't forget about the free community college and pre-K being talked about in the bill. Oh, we're getting to it. Senate Minority Leader Mitch McConnell told reporters last week that there is no enthusiasm among Republicans for a tax increase. You don't say. The Trojan horse will be called infrastructure. Inside the Trojan horse will be all the tax increases, McConnell said. The only way I think they could pull that off would be through a reconciliation process. Now, $3 trillion is a lot of money. That's a lot of money. Just for scale, we spend around $800 billion per year on the military. This would be basically a gigantic package. I mean, how much would it cost to do high-speed rail in the country? The cost per mile of the 520-mile California high-speed rail system, assuming it could actually be built, is $154 million. It's $80 billion. Amtrak's own estimates for replacing its existing northeast corridor with true high-speed rail work out to $500 million per mile. What the fuck? Why? That seems insane. But it only, I mean, look at this. We could actually afford to build high-speed rail if we invested that kind of money. Meanwhile, in China, it costs $17 million to $21 million per mile. Why could China build high-speed rail so cheaply? In under a decade, China has built a high-speed rail network totaling more than 110,000 kilometers. It eclipses every other country's high-speed network and even that of the entire European Union. Not only that, to build it, China spent two-thirds or less what other countries have spent. China's high-speed rail so far has cost between $17 million to $21 million per kilometer, even though it has a high ratio of big-ticket viaducts and tunnels. Some of the reasons are not surprising. For instance, the country where, according to the World Bank, 978 million people live on less than $5 a day, labor has been cheap. In an authoritarian state like China, the cost of moving people out of the way is low. The paper's authors note that site work and right-of-way costs in litigious California are around $10 million a kilometer. But the other reasons may be interesting to both the developed worlds and to regions like Africa that are sorely needed transformative infrastructure. For one thing, the sheer scale of China's rail program and the state firm's commitment to it unleashed the country's technical and manufacturing capability. The declaration of a credible plan to build 110,000 kilometers of high-speed rail over 6 to 7 years energized the construction and equipment supply community. Assured of very high volumes, companies and state institutions ramped up capacity quickly and invested in innovative techniques. This has led to lower unit costs as a result of the development of a competitive multiple local sources for construction that adopted mechanization and construction and manufacturing. Large volumes and the ability to amortize capital investment in high-cost construction equipment over a number of projects, contributing to the lowering of unit costs. The Chinese government also has the clout to standardize designs for embankments, track viaducts, electrification, signaling, and communication systems, which cuts costs and duplication of effort. It also standardized construction techniques. Here, the paper's authors admire the Chinese approach to viaducts. China built a lot of these to save scarce farmland or to leap over rivers, and even though they are expensive to build, the cost was kept down by standardizing the design and manufacture of viaduct bridge beams. Their span is standardized at either 24 meter or 32 meter, and they are cast in temporary factories set up along the railway alignment. Each beam is transported no more than 8 kilometers by a specially designed vehicle with up to 18 axles. They noted that China's system for tunnel construction resulted in a unit cost of 10 million to 15 million per kilometer, a fraction of what it costs in New Zealand, the U.S., and Australia. The system allowed China to tunnel fast, as well as a rate of 5 to 10 meters per day. But could the benefits of the Chinese approach be realized in big decentralized regions like the Gulf, Africa as a whole, or the United States? It seems unlikely. So this is something that I want to show you, chat, is that we could actually do this. If we spent this money competently, which is a big maybe, we could actually build a high-speed rail network. We could build a high-speed network like this. We've all seen this. Meme of what it would mean. And a high-speed rail network like this has already done in China. You look at this, you think, wow, this is crazy. But here's what it looks like. Look at the railway map of the People's Republic of China. Now, the blue lines are the 300 kilometer an hour lines. The green lines are 200 kilometers an hour, okay? So wherever you see green or blue, they have a network of high-speed rail. Pretty fucking nuts. And this is not a small country. China is not a small country. They can do it. In 10 years, we can do it too. The things blocking us are not the cost or the techniques. They are rather political. Political are the things blocking us from doing something like that. And when we have an infrastructure bill that's $3 trillion, we could afford to build a real high-speed rail network in this country, too. You heard it here first, folks. China is not a small country. You're welcome. It's not. I went from South China to Beijing in like 8 hours. Map from the High-Speed Rail Association. Bernie or Tulsi should announce a detailed high-speed rail plan for the country connecting major cities. Also an airport upgrade. That's what we could do with $3 trillion. I mean, we're even connecting Boise, for fuck's sake. Now, listen, you know. I mean, they connected Omaha, for fuck's sake. They connected Omaha eventually. I mean, who wants to do that? We could absolutely build something like this. And there should be a commitment to high-speed rail in this infrastructure package. It might help with the brain drain. Well, unironically, it would. If you have your cities with high-quality infrastructure well-connected to other cities, that makes your place more desirable to live in. The easier it is to travel to and from you. Like, we see this all the time. When a city builds a new metro station, that makes that neighborhood 10 times more desirable to live in. Because people hate commuting. They hate driving. Driving sucks shit. It's much nicer to wake up, walk onto a train, and then listen to a podcast, read a book, play a video game, and have your time be less consumed. Because when you're driving, you're locked into driving. That's the task you're doing. Your day is, and it costs a lot of money to maintain a car. It's a huge hassle. You have to pay for parking. Most people, a lot of people, don't like to drive to work. It sucks to be stuck in traffic. It blows. We do politics here every morning starting at 10 a.m. 10 a.m. Eastern, 7 a.m. Pacific. you can watch us here on Twitch. We're the morning guy, the morning politics guy, Politics Frogs, in every single day, same time, 10 a.m., day in, day out. And we carry you through your morning and early afternoon politics needs. And if you need more Mike from PA, we have a YouTube channel. We talked about suburbs, the MyPillow guy, Ted Cruz. We talked about DSA. Amazing. Making fun of Tim Pool. Amazing. Look at all of these amazing videos. Get in there, watch them. We have me on Twitter. You got to follow me on Twitter, chat. I'm at 20,614 subs. That means I got like 40 followers on Twitter in the last day. You can do better than that. You can do better than that. Go follow us on Twitter. And of course, join the Discord, where we have an incredible community of left-wing streamers. We have left-wing community. We talk about the stream. We talk about politics. There's gaming content. It's a really awesome, supportive place. Direct action, mutual aid. And you can just let off some steam. And also, you can help produce the show. One of the things I do is I look at the links that are put into the news content suggestions chat room on the Discord. Join the Discord, come hang out, and maybe what you want me to talk about will be part of the next show.